removing your testing system, it's important to review the lifting and handling section of the pre-installation manual included with your frame. This section provides essential information about site requirements, safety considerations, important do's and don'ts, and the weight and dimensional information specific to your system model. If you don't have a copy, one can be downloaded from Instron.com. We also recommend consulting with your organization's safety advisors to ensure you follow any internal guidance around moving heavy equipment. When it comes to moving a dual-column table model universal testing system, Instron strongly recommends using professional riggers experienced in moving heavy equipment. Anyone involved in the move should take care and wear the appropriate protective gear. For any new systems, please do not open any of the sealed packing boxes until the Instron service engineer arrives on site to perform the installation. Do not disassemble any components or parts from your Instron frame or accessories, and retain all packaging materials until the system is satisfactorily installed and all parts, assemblies, and accessories have been accounted for. When moving a testing system from your receiving area or within the lab, we recommend using a forklift. However, you can also use a pallet jack or crane where necessary. If you only have access to a crane, please reference the pre-installation manual for guidance. When moving your system via forklift, there are two methods to choose from: the shipping skid method and the crosshead method. If you have just received and uncrated your frame from Instron, it will arrive bolted to the skid. Before moving the skid, confirm the bolts are in place and that the crosshead is below the midpoint. Should you need to adjust the crosshead location without powering up the frame, you'll first need to move the upper and lower physical limit switches out of the way to prevent permanently damaging the safety equipment on your testing system. Then, remove the rear mat and base plug to expose the lay shaft assembly. Using a 19mm socket and power drill at low speed, lower the crosshead by turning the bolt counterclockwise until the crosshead is below the midpoint. Ensure that you stay clear of the crosshead when it is moving. Then, replace the plug and mat. At this point, you can carefully insert the forks of your forklift or jack under the shipping skid and move the system near its operating location and slowly lower it to the floor. Never attempt to lift the frame from below without the skid, or serious damage to the testing system will result. The crosshead method can be used to transport the load frame to the site location or to lift the frame onto a work surface. After moving the testing system via the shipping skid method, the first step is to remove the four bolts securing the frame to the skid using a 10mm hex tool. Then, using a forklift with padded forks or protective material between the forks and crosshead, carefully insert the forks under the crosshead between the columns. Ensure that all people in the immediate area are standing away before lifting. Be mindful of your surroundings and keep an eye on clearances anytime you move the load frame. Once the system clears the skid, pause the lift and remove it from the area before continuing to slowly move the frame to its operating location and carefully lower it into position. Never attempt to lift the testing system by the base or top plate. The base covers and top plate cannot support the weight of the frame. Attempting to lift the system in this manner may lead to personal injury and equipment damage. Finally, it's important to never tilt an unsupported system more than 10 degrees when it is in the upright position. Doing so may cause the load frame to topple. The system can be secured to the tabletop if necessary. If this is a site requirement for your lab, notify your Instron service representative for further guidance. If you have questions or would like further guidance on how to move your Instron testing system, please contact the Instron service team.